Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to our spring quarter graduation ceremony. We will begin the ceremony in just a few minutes, but before we do, I want to give you a few reminders and ask for your cooperation to ensure a great ceremony. Please move toward the center of your row to provide seats for those still trying to find seats. Please remain in your seats during the processional as the students, faculty, and platform party will be entering through both of the center aisles. Please keep them clear. Our command photographer will be taking photos of each graduate as they cross the stage to receive their completion certificate from our guest speaker, Admiral John M. Richardson, Chief of Naval Operations. These photos will be available for download next week on the Public Affairs or Current Students webpage. I would also like to point out the restrooms. The women's restroom is located in the far corner, stage right, and the men's restroom is located stage left. There are also restrooms located in the basement in the family-friendly room. If you wish to take photos during the ceremony, you may do so from your seats or from the outside aisles. Please do not enter the center aisle or the area in front of the stage. As a courtesy to everyone around you, please silence your mobile devices until the conclusion of today's ceremony. Also, for those of you with young children, we have set up a family-friendly room located in the basement of King Hall, which will have streaming video of the graduation should you need to use it. The ushers in the back of the auditorium are standing by to give you directions. The video of today's ceremony will be available on our internet site next week through video on demand. And finally, you have been listening to the Naval Postgraduate School's own Del Monte Brass. This is an all-volunteer group comprised of students, staff, faculty, retirees, and friends of the Naval Postgraduate School and Defense Language Institute communities under the direction of Lieutenant Michael Schwartz, a Naval Postgraduate School student. After the medley of armed services songs, you will hear the debut of a new musical piece entitled A Higher Velocity Learning. It was written as a graduation processional to honor the Naval Postgraduate School's critical role in the Navy's strategic line of effort for high velocity learning. It first features a musical idea that diffuses across different instruments to represent the spread of knowledge, then transitions into a militaristic theme to honor our culture of arms, and finally into a theme of calm reflection. This last theme then evolves into the busy rhythm of operations at sea, representing how time spent here will contribute to the grand image of maintaining maritime superiority. This piece was comprised by Lieutenant Michael Schwartz, who graduates today.
Thank you. Like Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, please stand for the presentation of colors and remain standing for the playing of our national anthem, Invocation. Color Guard, parade the colors. Color Guard, retire the colors. Chaplain Girolmo, Commander, United States Navy, will now deliver the invocation.
Let us pray. Eternal Father, we thank you for the privilege of celebrating the commencement of these men and women today as they graduate from the Naval Postgraduate School. You have sustained them over the course of their rigorous studies. The multiplicity of methods you have employed to impart knowledge, as well as the mentorship opportunities given to them through their faculty and advisors. For some, their time here at NPS has been challenging, personally and or professionally. For others, this has been a welcome break from a demanding up-tempo. However, by your grace, they are all here ready to enjoy the fruit of their labor. So now, as they prepare to receive their rightful diplomas and take on what lies ahead in their new jobs, whether in CONUS or abroad, I ask that you would graciously bless them and keep them. As you have strengthened them for the challenges here, give them assurance that you will do the same in the days ahead. For those of us who remain and carry on the work here at NPS, give us grace to follow the example they have set by continuing to pursue excellence in every endeavor. We honor them and their milestone today and praise you for this opportunity, and this treasured time together. In your name we pray, amen.
Please be seated. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Naval Postgraduate School's Spring Quarter Graduation. The men and women sharing the stage with President Rondeau and Provost Lehrman are the deans of our various schools, distinguished professors, U.S. government officials, and our local area military leadership. They have all been deeply involved in the education of today's graduates. I am honored to introduce our president, Vice Admiral Anne Rondeau, United States Navy retired.
Good morning. So, what a great morning this is to celebrate excellence, performance, and the expansion of knowledge. Today is a day of celebration not only for the achievement of our students, the support of their families and of their friends, and also to also celebrate the act of learning. So on that first celebration, I'd like to thank Michael Schwartz. Would you please stand up? Michael is the conductor for our Del Monte Brass. I was going to say the Monterey Brass, for our Del Monte Brass. And the march that you heard this morning is his composition, and it is called The March of Velocity Learning. Lieutenant, if that's not a suck up to the CNO, then nothing is.
I want a copy of that score.
And the lieutenant will be heading to 7th Fleet in Japan. He plays three different instruments. He's a math major, and math and music are parallel. And what a great way to learn and now give back to the fleet. Thank you, Michael. I also want to acknowledge in our audience this morning, Mrs. Dana Richardson. Dana, we thank you very much for all that you do and for not only your leadership as a Navy wife and a Navy mom, but also as you've led our Navy in these last 4 years. Thank you for what you've meant to our family and our Navy, Dana Richardson. Now, I'm going to call an audible. So if I could have all of the students and the soon-to-be graduates please stand. If I could ask the faculty and the deans and the chairs to please stand. And now, if as it fits, face each other. So I want the audience and the Chief of Naval Operations to know this is about, today's about an extraordinary thing that our Dean of Research recently said was the implicit contract. The implicit contract of learning, of teaching each other, of the notion that we're accountable for ourselves and our covenant, but we are obligated to each other for each other's success. And what we have at Naval Postgraduate School is a personification and the exemplified notion of the implicit contract from the learner and those who teach and the teachers who also learn. So this is, let us all please celebrate the notion of the implicit contract that's here and alive at Naval Postgraduate School. Thank you very much. Thank you. So this is a day to also talk about graduation. It's also talking about commencement. Now, if you look at the Latin word comite, it is a Latin word for the root, which will talk about commitment and about going forth and doing for others. That is what committee, commitment, commencement. It's about the beginning of further obligation. So we're going to talk about a lot of cool things today, but most importantly, we're going to be seeing our graduates coming across this stage from this way to this way. But I will tell you what is important is what they do when they walk out of here. And they walk to their new place in the Navy, the Army, the Marine Corps, the Coast Guard, the Air Force, and other government service. Today's a day of celebration, but also of a notion of that deep and abiding sense of commitment. So with that, I would like to also now introduce our guest speaker. He oftentimes has said he does not want to have his biography read, so it is in your program. What's important, though, is not in your program. This is a man who has exemplified a notion of his own continuous learning. He has been the CNO who has helped us to embark on the education for sea power. He is a CNO who has made policies and various kinds of leadership actions to make sure that our Navy is constantly learning in new ways so that we can have higher velocity of learning and thereby of acting and of being able to make faster and more accurate ways to making the kinds of decisions that are really important to our operational forces. This is a man who is here with his heart and his head, is also here with a legacy and the proven performance of a leader who has said, I want you to learn fast, and act well, and do good. I introduce to you Admiral Jonathan Richardson.
Well, thank you, President Rondeau, for that very gracious and kind introduction. And to everybody, just welcome. It's such a wonderful thing to be here today. It's one of my favorite things to do, to come out to Monterey and participate in any way I can with the Naval Postgraduate School, but particularly for graduation. I just want to welcome everybody here again. I would welcome certainly the distinguished faculty. Thank you for everything that you do to bring us to this day, to this culminating point. I want to thank all the family members who have come in from out of town and the family members who are here. You can hear all the young babies, right? That's another product of the Monterey experience. Is, you get how many of you had children while you were here in Monterey? There you go, see? So it's about, yeah, thank you, absolutely. So to all the family, the new family, and the friends, welcome. And then, of course, most importantly, to the graduating class. And I'll tell you what, as I settle into the podium, which takes me a little while, I want to just make sure we all settle in together. And it's going to be a bit of a kinetic talk that I'm going to give this morning. So if I could ask you just to warm up a little bit with me, if I could have everybody just sort of raise your right hand, just make sure they all work. Everybody, right hand up. Okay, good. That looks good. And left hand, please. Okay, all right. Now let me hear you clap, a little round of applause. Yeah. Okay, now listen about that clapping. I think it's because the U.S. Open is in town that you're all clapping like you're on the 18th hole or something like that. So let me hear just a round of a whooping applause here. Let's let it say there. Thank you. That is more like it. That is really more like it. I love speaking at graduations, and there are times of celebration, so let's be celebratory, right? And I'm also mindful that graduations have this special character that while we're here to celebrate a great accomplishment, particularly for the students of this school, everybody's got their car packed, everybody's got moved out of their quarters, their engines are running out there in the parking lot, and they are just, you know, revved. Everybody's revved to get on to the new thing. And they can't wait to get out of these dress uniforms into a T-shirt and board shorts and just hit the road for the next challenge. And so in recognition of that, I've pared my remarks down to about 45 minutes in terms of sharing what I think is the importance. And as the president said, I'm at the end of my term. I have a lot of wisdom to impart, and I'm not getting down until I'm done, okay? All right. Hey, how many folks are visiting for the ceremony from out of town? If we could just sort of raise your hand. Yeah, fantastic. Let's give all our visitors a nice round. I think all of our visitors would certainly say, everybody who's here in Monterey would say that Monterey is a very special place. And what a great spot for our postgraduate school, sort of nestled here in Monterey. Right down the road, you have the Monterey Bay Aquarium, which is a very special place in the research of ocean sciences, teaming together engineers and science in a very unique way. Of course, we're just a hop, skip, and a jump from Silicon Valley. And, well, I'll tell you, from the CNO perspective, I see the Naval Postgraduate School as our stepping stone into Silicon Valley, a way to, you know, harmonize with all of the creative energy there and all the creative energy here. And then there's so many other great schools in the neighborhood, whether that be Stanford or the schools in Los Angeles, San Diego, so many others. And there's that great center of learning that I know you've all spent time at, Pebble Beach Ball Golf Course, as well. And so what a great spot to come. And I love coming back here. And as I was preparing for my remarks today, I thought, as I always do for graduations, I want to get the best sense of the class as I can. And I thought one way to do that is to take a look at your theses. Okay, so last night after dinner, sat down, I confess I poured myself a nightcap, and I just started reading through the theses. After all, what better way to understand the sort of things that you've been thinking about in the past year or so? So the first one I picked up was, I'll just read you the title. It's Boron Nitride Nanotubes and Versatile Dielectrics for MEMS Electric Nose Radiation Detector. Okay? So I have to admit, Captain Gatz, that took a little while for me to warm up to. In fact, by the time I got through that thing, I was about halfway through that nightcap, and that wasn't helping. But I did get through it. I was pretty enthused, and so it was with some vigor that I picked up thesis number two, covert communications data frame structures using pulse position modulation, pulse shape modulation, preambles and postambles, and forward error correction. Okay? All right, so Lieutenant Schwartz, you gave me a challenge, but we got through that. I'm reading, I'm sipping, my confidence is building, and then I run into one a little bit different, a little bit less technical, running dry, water scarcity in Pakistan. Okay, now this was a little bit more approachable because at least it was written in English, all right? And I could, and then the whole running dry thing reminded me that I was also running dry, and so I went and refilled my drink and kept on going, all right? Next one I came upon was dissuading young potential terrorists, okay? That was a little bit too close to home. Dane and I have 5 kids, and I think that if our, our parenting could be summed up in just sort of dissuading young potential terrorists. So, at this point, I was getting, a little bit distressed. I mean, the technical one's early on, and now this potential terrorist thing, I was starting to get a little bit nervous. Thank goodness the last one I picked up was wave run up on a steep rocky beach with a small river plume, all right? And that was more like it, a nice beach, perhaps a towel and an umbrella, a picnic and a boogie board. And it was with that vision that I slipped away into sleep and was completely ready for events this morning. All right? And it worked. Reading your theses gave me a great sense of your class. And I will tell you that one thing that becomes very clear reading through the work of the class is that the world out there is extremely complicated. It is complex. And it is moving faster and faster every single day. But reading your work gave me tremendous confidence that you are ready for this challenge, and that this graduating class, as they go back into where they're going to work, enter the mainstream, if you will, this class represents a tremendous addition to the strategic arsenal of our nation and the nations represented here by the international students. I will tell you that many graduate schools around the nation do great work and they solve many problems. But the Naval Postgraduate School does great work and it solves our problems, right? That's why this is a special place for us. And many schools, when they have ceremonies like this, they produce graduates. But this school, by virtue of its unique place and unique student body, produces leaders. Leaders who are ready and willing to go out and step into the whitewater rapids of the current environment and tackle this complexity, this challenge, and this pace head on. Leaders who are not only experts at what they do, technical experts, but also who are leaders of integrity and character, and leaders who are and will remain highly connected in support of one another. Now, I'll tell you, as I have said before, and as you heard from President Rondeau, you know, pace is one of the words that is often used to describe our strategic environment. Accelerating pace, exponential pace. You hear all sorts of ways to describe it, but they all try and, you know, convey this sense that things are moving fast. Our competitors are working very hard to outpace us, to learn faster than we are learning. This competitive force should spur us on to act with a great sense of urgency. And the challenges that we face as a Navy and a nation are existential and demand the complete totality of our effort. We need to dedicate every molecule of our energy to making sure that we come out on the top end of this competition. And I'll tell you what, I'm sure you've heard this before, that if you want to think about a new way to do things, read an old book. And I would recommend that if you haven't read it already, there's a great book by a man named Trent Hone called Learning War. And it describes the Navy at the turn of the 1900s, right around the time when the Naval Postgraduate School was born. And it talks about the challenges that we faced as a nation as we loosed the continental bonds and became a global power, a power that would need to rely on shipping and sea trade to continue to prosper. Oh, by the way, at the same time, they were going through the Industrial Revolution, very much like we're going through the Information Revolution right now. And this book is very clear about the role that places like the Naval Postgraduate School and the Naval War College played. They were stood up to develop a leadership cadre that was prepared to take on both this new global role and also these technical challenges that were upon us. And this started the learning engine that our Navy continues to strive to be every single day. And it made all the difference in World War II. So this task that is before us is not all completely new. And while the security environment differs in many key ways than the one that existed at the beginning of World War II, the culture that we need to address those differences is part of our heritage, okay? And I would argue that learning is, in fact, part of the Navy's DNA. And as graduate students, it's really, you know, what you have learned to date is part of what we celebrate today. But what I am excited about is that you've learned not only your material, but you've learned how to learn. You've learned the process of learning. And so I would encourage you to just commit that your time here in Monterey is not an end to learning, but it's just a beginning. Exactly as President Rondeau said, this is a commencement. And so just as you've done here, learning in the fleet requires you to go out and form hypotheses, to go out and run those hypotheses through some kind of a test, to compare the results that you see, which are almost never the results you set out to achieve, to figure out what the differences were all about, make adjustments to your plan, and run it again. This is the scientific method that I know has been stressed here in Monterey. And don't worry about making mistakes here, right? Don't forget, it took Edison 10,000 times to build a light, make a light bulb that would last. And he's got that great quote, "I didn't fail 10,000 times, I just learned 10,000 ways not to make a light bulb," okay? Key word in there is learn, right? As long as we're learning from every one of those episodes, then we're making progress, all right? Take this spirit of learning forward into your career. Compel your teams, the teams you will lead, to bring that learning spirit on as well. The key to tightening this spirit is bringing theory and practice together, right? Have that plan. Try it out, and then see how it goes. Learn from that experiment and do it. This is simple to say, but much harder to do. It's going to require a dedicated effort, and it's going to require a lot of energy. But I will tell you, it will make you expert leaders, leading expert teams, and you will achieve best ever performance by doing that. So you will become leaders of competence by taking this learning spirit forward. Now, I will tell you, as I said at the beginning, it's not just what you've learned here at Monterey, but it's how you've learned it, the environment. This environment is a climate defined by service to something bigger than ourselves. As Admiral Rondeau mentioned, we had a great discussion yesterday with the faculty. The faculty that is so extremely talented. And I gotta say that this faculty has a lot of choices. They could go anywhere in the world and teach, right? But they come here. And they came here, they come here and they stay here because of this bond, this implicit contract that the president mentioned that forms between a student and the teacher. Every one of the faculty teaches. There are no teaching assistants here. The faculty is engaged. And as we talked over lunch, it became clear that one of the reasons they teach here in Monterey is that they love the ethic of service, the atmosphere of honor, courage, and commitment that is woven into the fabric here at the Naval Postgraduate School. They love your selfless approach to studying and research. All you want to do is get smarter. You just want to learn, right? No, you don't care about who gets the credit. This is the same spirit with the faculty as well. This place is dedicated not only to solving the Navy's problems, but doing so in a way that strengthens the Navy's integrity, strengthens our accountability, our initiative, and our toughness. So to the graduating class, your teachers have invested in you, and as you go off to literally go around the world, some of them goes with you as you leave. So I would ask you to please stand. Find your advisor. Stand, yeah, stand. That's an order. All right. Find your advisor, face them, and give them all, the faculty, a great round of applause for everything that they have invested in you. Okay, seats. All right, so we've talked about the fact that you're going to be expert leaders, leaders of competence. We've talked about that your experience here has also strengthened you as leaders of character. I would ask you just to consider one other element as you leave here today. You know, as we work on the technical issues, as we explore the frontiers of technology and naval power, I would say that the connections you have formed here are as important as anything else you've done. These connections make us stronger professionally as we can share lessons learned among ourselves. They also make us stronger and more resilient personally, right? You're gonna have bad days out there, and it's always great when you can call someone up and say, let me just tell you how terrible my day was, and they can say, you know what? I had a worse one yesterday. You're going to be fine. You're going to get through it, right? And you've made these connections with your faculty, with the people that you've traveled around the country and saw and connected with as you did your research. You made certainly connections as a class with your fellow students, which is also very special because you have a number of international students here. And so you've made international connections. These connections with our allies and partners, your classmates, are going to serve you well. And as you go forward and become leaders together in your respective services, in your respective nations, these relationships will come in handy. I will tell you what, when the fighting starts, and we have never fought alone in this country, we're not going to do it in the future, when that alliance forms, you can call up someone that you studied with here in Monterey, that bond of friendship, that bond of trust, will serve you very well, and things will happen much, much more effectively and much faster. And so, yep, go ahead. Right. Okay, so I am so thrilled that amongst us today, I think there are 25 international students who will graduate. Your presence here adds a special and unique dimension to the learning that happens here. You You make so much stronger the intellectual life, but also just the cultural life, the social life here, by bringing all of your culture and traditions. And as I said, it strengthens those bonds of trust and confidence. So could I ask all of our international students and their families to please stand and allow us to recognize you. So stand on up there, everybody. Okay, good. Thank you. Thank you all very much for joining us here in Monterey and adding so much to our education. You've made lifelong friends, and that's important. Now, how many in the audience here are parents of one of the graduates? Raise your hand if you're a parent, all right? All right, parents, I've got to tell you what, I'm a parent of a graduate too, right? I'm not kidding, it's true. Up to now, I have spoken to you as your commencement speaker, as the Chief of Naval Operations, but now it's time to speak as a proud dad, and this is the great reveal.
Nate, I am your father.
Okay. I will tell you what, to all of the parents here, it is no accident that your children are here, that they are people of competence, that they are people of character, and they are deeply connected with their friends and faculty. And the DNA of service and sacrifice was planted in them way before they got here. It was bestowed on them and taught them by all of the parents. And I know to the graduates, your families share the same pride that Dana and I feel with Nathan. And so for all of you, stand up again, find your parents in the audience, and give them a round of applause. So stand. You guys are slow today. Stand. There you go. Give your parents a round of applause. There they are. Look at them. Okay. They're so super proud of you. That's fantastic. Okay, I'll wrap it up here. As your time in Monterey for the graduating class draws to a close, please remember what you've learned here. Remember who you learned with. Remember who taught you. As you go off, be leaders of competence, be leaders of character, be leaders who remain highly connected. And in doing so, you will ensure that our Navy remains the safest Navy for our sailors, the best partner Navy for all of our friends and allies, and the absolute worst nightmare to anyone who would try to be our enemy. Thank you all. God bless you. God bless the United States Navy. And God bless the United States. Thank you very much.
I invite President Rondeau, Provost Lehrman, and Admiral Richardson forward for the conferring of degrees to the graduate candidates. Will the candidates for the engineer's degree please stand and proceed to the platform?
The engineer's degree is a degree that is intermediate between a master's degree and a PhD. It requires more courses than a master's degree, and the student spends more time in the thesis investigation, probing deeper into research than for a master's thesis. President Rondeau, I present to you these candidates. After consideration of their academic accomplishments, the Academic Council will recommend them for the degree Electrical Engineer.
Upon the recommendation of the Academic Council, I will, by the authority vested in me, confer upon them the degree of Electrical Engineer as specified with all the rights, privileges, and responsibilities thereunto pertaining.
Also receiving the degree Master of Science in Electrical Engineering and the recipient of the Space and Naval Warfare Systems Command Award in Electronic Systems Engineering, Lieutenant Dimitrios Canavaros, Hellenic Navy. Also receiving the degree Master of Science in Electrical Engineering, Lieutenant Theodoros Karapas, Hellenic Navy. Also receiving the degree Master of Science in Electrical Engineering and graduating with distinction, Lieutenant Junior Grade Petros Siritogoulou, Hellenic Navy. Will the candidates for the degrees Master of Arts, Master of Science, and Master of Business Administration please stand?
President Rondeau, I present to you these candidates. After consideration of their academic accomplishments, the Academic Council will recommend them for the degree Master of Arts, Master of Science, and Master of Business Administration as specified.
Upon the recommendation of the Academic Council, I will, by the authority vested in me, confer upon them the degree of Master of Arts, Master of Science, and Master of Business Administration as specified with all the rights, privileges, and responsibilities thereunto pertaining.
Remaining candidates, please be seated. Master of Science in Electrical Engineering, Captain Kevin Patrick McFerrin, United States Army. Ensign Maeve Brogue, United States Navy. The recipient of the John McReynolds Wozencraft Electrical and Computer Engineering Academic Honor Award, Ensign Joseph Austin Brueger, United States Navy. Lieutenant Commander Jose Fernandez, United States Navy. The recipient of the Captain David S. Bill Jr. Leadership Award, Lieutenant Ryan Brady Goldsmith, United States Navy. Ensign Armando Andres Rivera, United States Navy. Your conductor for the Del Monte Brass, Lieutenant Michael Schwartz, United States Navy. The recipient of the Fleet Cyber Command Award for Academic Achievement in Cyber Operations, Lieutenant Commander Joseph Hainsworth, United States Coast Guard. Master of Science in Engineering Science, Electrical Engineering, Lieutenant Kevin Lee Rawlson, United States Coast Guard. Master of Science in Applied Physics. Graduating with distinction, Captain John Vandersite Gatz, United States Marine Corps. The recipient of the Johns Hopkins Applied Physics Laboratory Award for Excellence in Applied Physics Research, Major Jared McDonald Robinson, United States Marine Corps. With an outstanding thesis, Lieutenant Colonel Nasser Krizu, Canadian Army. Lieutenant Benjamin John Carpenter, United States Navy. Lieutenant Darian Cornelius Green, United States Navy. Lieutenant Zeeshan Hamid, United States Navy. The recipient of the Naval Sea Systems Command Award for Excellence in Combat Systems, Lieutenant Loy Van Hoon, United States Navy. Lieutenant Commander Sangmin Lee, Republic of Korea Navy. Lieutenant Steven Seda, United States Navy. Master of Science in Engineering Acoustics with an outstanding thesis, Lieutenant Alberto Antonio Espinosa Peyrot, Mexican Navy. Master of Science in Physical Oceanography, graduating with distinction and an outstanding thesis, Lieutenant Timothy Forge, Royal Australian Navy. Master of Science in Meteorology and Physical Oceanography, Lieutenant Commander Robert Carter, United States Navy. Graduating with distinction and an outstanding thesis, Lieutenant Jillian Nicole Coughlin, United States Navy. The recipient of the Oceanographer of the Navy Award for Outstanding Academic Performance in the Meteorology and Oceanography Curriculum, graduating with distinction and an outstanding thesis, Lieutenant Travis James Davis, United States Navy. Lieutenant Natasha Louise Reed, United States Navy. Lieutenant Commander Nicholas Verhoeven, United States Navy. Lieutenant Commander Ka Shong, United States Navy. Master of Arts in Security Studies, Middle East, South Asia, Sub-Saharan Africa, Major United States Marine Corps. Ensign Zachary Anderson, United States Navy. Ensign Brittany Barrickman, United States Navy. Ensign Elise Mizaros, United States Navy. Major Eric Beebe, United States Air Force. The recipient of the Air Force Association Award for Outstanding Air Force Student, Major Michelle Dryden, United States Air Force. Major Nicholas Kamen, United States Air Force. The recipient of the Foreign Area Officer Association Award for Excellence in International Affairs and graduating with distinction, Major Norman Wilson, United States Air Force. Master of Arts in Security Studies, Far East, Southeast Asia, and the Pacific, Captain Stephanie Bent, United States Marine Corps. With an outstanding thesis, Major Jason Davidson, United States Marine Corps. Captain Michael Smith, United States Marine Corps. Lieutenant Ashley Allison, United States Navy. Lieutenant Anton Balsero, United States Navy. The recipient of the Lewis D. Liskin Award for Excellence in Regional Security Studies, graduating with distinction, Lieutenant Kelly Bischoff, United States Navy. Lieutenant Stephanie Bro, United States Navy. Lieutenant Jeremy Brooks, United States Navy. Lieutenant Christopher Wayner, United States Navy. Lieutenant Daniel Godkin, United States Navy. Lieutenant Shin Pfeiffer, United States Navy. Graduating with distinction, Ensign Philip Ramirez, United States Navy. Ensign Benjamin Smart, United States Navy. Ensign Suzelle Thomas, United States Navy. Major Alana Keith, United States Air Force. Master of Arts in Security Studies, Western Hemisphere, Major David Del Valle, United States Marine Corps. Lieutenant Ryan Sorge, United States Navy. With an outstanding thesis, Lieutenant Stephen Tynes, United States Navy. Captain Jason Zyberski, United States Air Force. Master of Arts in Security Studies, Europe and Eurasia, Captain Holly Berger, United States Marine Corps. Captain Austin Burns, United States Marine Corps. Major Brad Hull, United States Marine Corps. With an outstanding thesis, Major Brian Luzinski, United States Marine Corps. Captain Daniel Spanu, United States Marine Corps. Lieutenant Laurel Fernandez, United States Navy. Ensign Kayla Savage, United States Navy. Lieutenant Commander Slavko Strezowski, United States Navy. The recipient of the Gary Laughlin Patriot Award and the Naval Postgraduate School Superior Service Award, Major Caitlin Diffley, United States Air Force. The recipient of the Outstanding United States Air Force Graduate Award from the Department of National Security Affairs and graduating with distinction, Major Peter Larson, United States Air Force. The recipient of the International Student Award for Excellence in Regional Security Studies, Lieutenant Colonel Sasha Donath, German Air Force. The recipient of the International Student Award for Excellence in Regional Security Studies and the Naval Postgraduate School Outstanding Academic Achievement Award for International Student and graduating with distinction, Lieutenant Colonel Heiko Bonsack, German Army. Lieutenant Colonel Kai Litch, German Army. Master of Arts in Security Studies, Strategic Studies, Major Dao Ibrahima, Mali National Police. Master of Arts in Security Studies, Major Kamara Yahaya, Mali Armed Forces National Police. Master of Arts in Security Studies, Homeland Security and Defense, Lieutenant Christopher Fontana, United States Navy. Master of Arts in Security Studies, Combating Terrorism, Policy and Strategy, Lieutenant Colonel Muhammad Jamil, Pakistan Army. Lieutenant Commander Febrianto Nuguro, Indonesian Navy. Master of Science in Astronautical Engineering, Ensign Aaron Ashley Colton, United States Navy. with an outstanding thesis, Ensign Zachary Lewis, United States Navy. Ensign Joshua Ten Ike, United States Navy. Master of Science in Engineering Science, Aerospace Engineering, Ensign Benjamin Anderson, United States Navy. The recipient of the Commander Naval Air Forces Award for Excellence in Aviation Warfare and with an outstanding thesis, Ensign Matthew Baugh, United States Navy. Ensign Grant McClellan Robertson, United States Navy. With an outstanding thesis, Ensign Grant Thornton, United States Navy. Ensign Robert Thyberg II, United States Navy. Master of Science in Mechanical Engineering, Lieutenant Martin Brantner, United States Navy. Lieutenant Matthew Busta, United States Navy. The recipient of the Naval Sea Systems Command Award in Naval Mechanical Engineering, graduating with distinction and an outstanding thesis, is Commander Durward Dunn IV, United States Navy. Graduating with distinction, Lieutenant Spencer Lee Ewing, United States Navy. Ensign William Gompertz, United States Navy. Ensign Joshua Hanna, United States Navy. Lieutenant Commander Keenan Harmon, United States Navy. With an outstanding thesis, Lieutenant Michael Keim, United States Navy. Ensign Brianna Marie Kaufman, United States Navy. Ensign Josh LaFlamme, United States Navy. Ensign Julian Martinez, United States Navy. Ensign Connor Panic, United States Navy. Ensign Sarah Grace Riley, United States Navy. Lieutenant Junior Grade Wilson Reidulch, United States Navy. Lieutenant Gabriel Supi, United States Navy. Lieutenant Christia Suribin, United States Navy. Master of Science in Space Systems Operations, Captain Robert Costello, Jr., United States Marine Corps. With an outstanding thesis, Major Jason Allen Kozak, United States Marine Corps. Graduating with distinction and an outstanding thesis, Captain Dylan Pierce, United States Marine Corps. The recipient of the Space Systems Operations Award for Academic Excellence, Major John Pross, United States Marine Corps. Lieutenant Colonel Kurt Schweitzer, United States Army. Lieutenant Stuart Archer, United States Navy. Lieutenant Daniel Derricks, United States Navy. Lieutenant Joseph Gilley, United States Navy. Lieutenant Robert McLennan, United States Navy. Lieutenant Michelle Verbeck, United States Navy. Master of Science in Systems Engineering Analysis, Lieutenant Francis Aaron Antonio, United States Navy. Lieutenant Scott Constantine, United States Navy. Lieutenant Dolph Ike Jr., United States Navy. Lieutenant Joseph Emil Hanasek, United States Navy. Lieutenant Nick Morgan, United States Navy. Master of Science in Systems Engineering, Lieutenant Sammy Amala, United States Navy. The recipient of the Surface Navy Association's Award for Excellence in Surface Warfare Research, Lieutenant Kyle Chance. Navy. Lieutenant Lauren Howard, United States Navy. Graduating with distinction, Lieutenant Commander Brian Newgren, United States Navy. Lieutenant Joel Michael Heyman, United States Navy. I got this. Mrs. Vimalis Manfredo, Naval Undersea Warfare Center, Newport. Ms. Lena Catherine Nelson, Naval Undersea Warfare Center, Newport. Master of Science in Engineering Systems, Ms. Tiffany Elizabeth Jackson Henderson, Naval Undersea Warfare Center, Newport. Master of Science in Operations Research, Major Brandon Bowman, United States Marine Corps. Major Daniel Oscar Diaz, United States Marine Corps. Major Kevin Joseph Doherty, United States Marine Corps. Major Joshua Edward Fawcett, United States Marine Corps. Major Joshua Gordon, United States Marine Corps. Major Gregory Ellsworth Lynch, United States Marine Corps. Captain Gregory Wendell Mateo, United States Marine Corps. Captain Thomas Patrick, United States Marine Corps. Also receiving a degree Master of Science in Applied Mathematics and graduating with distinction, Major Matthew Thomas Miller, United States Marine Corps. Major Joseph Eric Moeller, United States Marine Corps. With an outstanding thesis, Captain Alyssa Reynosto, United States Marine Corps. Also receiving a degree Master of Science in Applied Mathematics with an outstanding thesis, Captain Christopher Joseph Teska, United States Marine Corps. The recipient of the Monterey Peninsula Council Navy League Award for Highest Academic Achievement and the Military Operations Research Society Stephen A. Tisdale Graduate Research Award, graduating with distinction and an outstanding thesis, Captain Courtney Thompson, United States Marine Corps. Major Howard James Barrow, United States Army. Captain Aaron Lincoln Devig, United States Army. Major Gabriel Alejandro Gobaya, United States Army Reserve. Major Daniel Raymond Hudala, United States Army. Major Jared Donald Kasolki, United States Army. Major Jan Lim, Australian Army. Captain Sarah Martin, United States Army. Major Robert Lawrence Page, United States Army. The recipient of the Association of the United States Army General Joseph W. Stillwear Chapter Award for Outstanding Army Student graduating with distinction, Major Gabriel Martin Samudio, United States Army. Major James Edward Streams, United States Army. Lieutenant Kyle Belcher, United States Navy. Master of Science in Applied Science Operations Research, the recipient of the Chief of Naval Operations Award for Excellence in Operations Research and an Outstanding Thesis, Ensign Zachary Taylor Scholes, United States Navy. Ensign Matthew Vogel, United States Navy. Master of Science in Information Strategy and Political Warfare, Major Tad Edward Pugh, United States Army. Master of Science in Defense Analysis, First Lieutenant Samir Chuka, Albanian Army. Graduating with distinction and an outstanding thesis, Lieutenant Colonel Matthias Fiala, Swiss Armed Forces. Graduating with distinction, Major Bernardus Hospuls, Royal Netherlands Army. Major William McMurray, United States Army. Major Espen Ulvebna, Norwegian Army. Lieutenant William Wesley Bochner, United States Navy. Graduating with distinction, Lieutenant Commander Casey Hamblin, United States Navy. Lieutenant Thomas Patrick McNeil, United States Navy. Lieutenant Jeffrey Moran Mann, United States Navy. Senior Chief Petty Officer Bradford Raymond West, United States Navy. The recipient of the Air Force Association Award for Outstanding U.S. Air Force Student graduating with distinction and an outstanding thesis, Major Robert Andrew Davidson, United States Air Force. Major Joseph Daniel Davis, United States Air Force. Senior Master Sergeant Alex John Udy, United States Air Force. With an outstanding thesis, Major Philip Garrito, United States Air Force. Major Matthew Ortego Ridaja, United States Air Force. Lieutenant Colonel John David Topher, United States Air Force. Master of Science in Computer Science, Major Ryan Michael Ackland, United States Marine Corps. The recipient of the Rear Admiral Grace Murray Hopper Computer Science Award, graduating with an outstanding thesis, Major Lucas John Burke, United States Marine Corps. With an outstanding thesis, Major Brent Edward Logan, United States Marine Corps. With an outstanding thesis, Captain John Oliver Mutton, United States Marine Corps. Major Joseph Anthony Plott, United States Marine Corps. Captain Brittany Elise Snellgrove, United States Marine Corps. Captain Michael Whitaker, United States Marine Corps. Major Justin Eastman, United States Army. Lieutenant Joseph Cameron Acevez, United States Navy. Lieutenant Junior Grade Devin Edward Budzitowski, United States Navy. Lieutenant Britt Jackson Campbell, United States Navy. Lieutenant Scott Edwin Findlay, United States Navy. Lieutenant Carlos Fuentes Hargett, United States Navy. With an outstanding thesis, Lieutenant Corey David Ingraham, United States Navy. Lieutenant Marion Mackenzie Kendrick, United States Navy. Ensign Timothy Reinhold Naske, United States Navy. The recipient of the Rear Admiral Grace Murray Hopper Computer Science Award, graduating with distinction and an outstanding thesis, Lieutenant Commander Nathan James Richardson, United States Navy. Lieutenant Zachy Rucker, United States Navy. Master of Science in Modeling, Virtual Environments, and Simulation, Captain Kevin Javon Ayers, United States Marine Corps. Commander Daniel Lee Kane, United States Navy. Major Aaron Katie Demchko, United States Marine Corps. The recipient of the Marine Corps Association Superior Service Award for Outstanding U.S. Marine Student and the Commander George L. Phillips Modeling Virtual Environments and Simulation Award, graduating with distinction and an outstanding thesis, Captain. Captain Peter Severson, United States Marine Corps. The recipient of the Commander George L. Phillips Modeling Virtual Environments and Simulation Award, graduating with an outstanding thesis, Captain Laura Courtney Thomerson, United States Marine Corps. Master of Science in Cyber Systems and Operations, Major Gonzalo Santiago, United States Army. Lieutenant Commander Adam Humphrey, United States Navy. Lieutenant Gary Lynn Lattimore, United States Navy. Master of Science in Systems Technology, Command, Control, and Communications, the recipient of the John McReynolds Wozencraft Electrical and Computer Engineering Academic Honor Award and the Joint Chiefs of Staff Command Control Communication Computers and Intelligence Award for Academic Achievement, Major Justin Paul Murphy, United States Marine Corps. Lieutenant Junior Grade Armando Cruz Ojeda, Mexican Navy. Master of Science in Network Operations and Technology, Captain Jonathan David Asbill, United States Army. Lieutenant Raza Pervez Beg, United States Navy. Lieutenant Commander Beverly Ann Scott Crawford, United States Navy. Lieutenant Jeffrey Bruce Grooms, United States Navy. Lieutenant Charisse Shante Miller, United States Navy. Lieutenant Daniel Minter, United States Navy. Lieutenant Ina Stukova Robinson, United States Navy. Yeah. Lieutenant Kubi Russell Smith, United States Navy. Lieutenant Commander Christopher Edward Sousa, United States Navy. Master of Science in Information Warfare Systems Engineering, also receiving the degree Master of Science in Space Systems Operations, Captain Christine Dulnig Abercrombie, United States Marine Corps. With an outstanding thesis, Captain Yusuf Akbarut, United States Marine Corps. Captain Ian Carter, United States Marine Corps. Captain Michael Aloysius Cybulski, United States Marine Corps. With an outstanding thesis, Major Joel Michael Katz, United States Marine Corps. Also receiving the degree Master of Science in Applied Mathematics, graduating with distinction, Major Paul Keeley, United States Marine Corps. Also receiving the degree Master of Science in Systems Engineering, Major Eric Ryan Stewart, United States Marine Corps. Captain Edward Scott Yarborough, Jr., United States Marine Corps. Science in Management, Manpower, Systems Analysis, Lieutenant Bryce Christensen, United States Navy. Lieutenant Commander Amanda Chaberas, United States Navy. Master of Business Administration, Acquisition and Contract Management, Lieutenant Commander Scott Edward Adams, United States Navy. Lieutenant Mark Ajay, United States Navy. The recipient of the Distinguished Professor Kenneth J. Yuski Dean's Medal for Innovation Contribution to National Defense, the Graduate School of Business and Public Policy, and with an outstanding thesis, Lieutenant Commander John Bing, United States Navy. Lieutenant Commander Bradford Edenfield, United States Navy. Lieutenant Commander Malcolm Elliott, United States Navy. The recipient of the Distinguished Professor Kenneth J. Yuski Dean's Medal for Innovative Contribution to National Defense, and with an outstanding thesis, Lieutenant Commander Jeffrey United States Navy. Of the Distinguished Professor Kenneth J. Yuski Dean's Medal for Innovation Contribution to National Defense, and with an outstanding thesis, Major Michael Huddleston, Jr., United States Army. Lieutenant Hui Fen Wang, Taiwan Navy. Lieutenant Commander Ying Zong, United States Navy. Master of Business Administration, Defense and Business Management, Mr. Tyler Williamson, Naval Postgraduate School. Master of Business Administration, Defense Business Management International, Lieutenant Kazuma Yoshida, Japan Navy. Master of Business Administration, Systems Acquisition Management, with an outstanding thesis, Lieutenant Commander Jeff Lou Findlay, United States Navy. With an outstanding thesis, Lieutenant Commander Jeff Pinkerton, United States Navy. Master of Business Administration, Transportation Management, Captain Ashion Midori Izadi, United States Army. Master of Business Administration, Supply Chain Management, the recipient of the Naval Supply Systems Command Award for Academic Excellence in Management, Lieutenant Commander Shannon Percival, United States Navy. The recipient of the Rear Admiral Donald R. Eaton Logistics Award for Outstanding Achievement, graduating with distinction, Lieutenant Jonah Petrinovich, United States Navy. Lieutenant Commander Clifford Rivera, United States Navy. Lieutenant Commander James Steele, United States Navy. Lieutenant Commander Long Kim Tran, United States Navy. The recipient of the Master of Business Administration Financial Management, the recipient of the Lewis D. Liskin Award for Excellence in Management, and the recipient of the Department of the Navy Award for Academic Excellence in Financial Management, graduating with distinction, Commander David Tickle, United States Navy. Lieutenant Commander Jennifer Charlton, United States Navy. Lieutenant Wanda Colon, United States Navy. The recipient of the Graduate School of Business and Public Policy Faculty Outstanding International Student Award, Lieutenant Colonel Roberto do Nascimento Pinheiro, Brazilian Air Force. Lieutenant Commander Jeffrey Johnson, United States Navy Reserve. Lieutenant Commander Zach Manriquez, United States Navy. The recipient of the Conrad Scholar Award for Academic Excellence in Financial Management, Lieutenant Timothy Michael McDaniel, United States Navy. Lieutenant Commander Benjamin Petrison, United States Navy. The recipient of the Conrad Scholar Award for Academic Excellence in Financial Management, graduating with distinction, Lieutenant Jonathan Ryan Wheeler, United States Navy. Master of Business Administration, Information Systems Management, the recipient of the Graduate School of Business and Public Policy Faculty Outstanding International Student Award, Major Pyojong Kim, Korean Army. Master of Business Administration, Material Logistics Support Management, Lieutenant Gilbert Garcia, Jr., United States Navy. Master of Science in Contract Management, Mr. Jeffrey Bresini, NAVSUP. Mr. Nick Giacalone, NAVSUP. Mr. Brian Keyes from PEO Information Systems. Graduating with distinction, Mr. Philip Lee, Office of Naval Research. Mr. Jeffrey Marsh, Naval Undersea Warfare Center, Keyport. Mr. Michael Nagy, Naval Undersea Warfare Center, Keyport. Mr. Hui Nguyen, US DCMA. Ms. Janessa Shanton, NASA. Ms. Susan Stewart, Wright-Patterson Air Force Base, graduating with distinction. Ms. Shyla Weiss, Hill Air Force Base.
That's it, sir.
Join me in giving all our graduates a well-deserved round of applause. Please stand or remain standing. Chaplain Giralmo, Commander, United States Navy, will now give the benediction.
Let us pray. Our God of grace and mercy, you inspire all who trust in you with encouraging words. Well done, thy good and faithful servant. May these graduates endeavor as leaders to pursue excellence in all their work, granting them continued success in the days ahead. May the light of your Son and the life of your Spirit bless us now with renewed confidence and peace. Work in us and through us that which is pleasing in your sight. Blessed be your name now and forever. Amen.
Ladies and gentlemen, this concludes today's graduation ceremony. On behalf of the President, Provost, and all of us at the Naval Postgraduate School, once again, thank you for being here today. We offer our sincere appreciation to the Naval Postgraduate School Color Guard and the Del Monte Brass. Please remain clear of the aisles until the platform party and faculty have departed. President Rondeau and Provost Lehrman cordially invite graduates, faculty, and guests to a reception in honor of the graduates in the Barbara McNitt Ballroom of Herman Hall immediately following the ceremony. ¶¶